Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We ask that Allah Azza wa Jal on this blessed night, the first night of Ramadan, Sunday, that He make this month a most special month for us, that He Jalla wa Ala make this Ramadan one of the most beautiful Ramadans that we will have ever experienced. Allahumma ameen. To better help us in doing this ahibati, I ask that we pay attention to some of the different messages that are going to be directed towards us, the congregation as a whole, so that the experience is going to truly be better for each and every one of us. Today, we want to especially focus on safety and security. So as we think about safety and security, first and foremost, I would hope that we could all understand that we have to be directly participating to better ensure that everyone, especially the most vulnerable, which are our children, that every one of us is being the eyes and ears for the community, for our children, excuse me, and that each and every one of us is doing the best that we can. So among the things that we want to pay attention to, brothers and sisters, is that when you come to the masjid with your children, and we encourage you to come to worship together as a family, that you, the parents, please do the best to make sure that you speak to your children beforehand. Help them to understand that their safety is not to be taken lightly, rather their safety is from the greatest of importance. And in order for that to be ensured, that they need to listen to the directions that you're giving them, that they need to follow your teachings as best as possible. And of them is that they should be with you. Fathers, we ask that your younger children, that you keep them with you. Mothers, that you have your daughters with you, and that you worship together. There's going to be, as always, designated areas for parents with their children, so that this way you can have better peace of mind, and that the congregation, the jama'ah as a whole, is going to be well. Of these teachings also for safety and security, and I ask that our adolescents and everyone else of our teenagers pays attention to, is that we be cautious to not leave the premises. As we're told that sometimes they feel, you know, they want to go to 7-Eleven, to McDonald's, to Brahms, and who knows what, and they're just having fun, and they're thinking that, you know, everything is just fine. Well, alhamdulillah that we have not had anything of a serious incident to take place. But we need to make sure that we are doing our best to keep the situation as such. Do not leave the premises. Do not at night go wandering off to any of these locations. Number one, we're at a very dangerous intersection where there's high traffic, high volume, and cars are going at high speeds. The second thing is that there is a bit of a distance and you have no idea who may be present, who may be watching, especially with regards to what we have seen most recently with the attacks. The other thing is that in the facility itself, do not be alone, especially for our younger kids. Do not be alone. There's going to be babysitting services, or what may even be better than that, child care services, where there's going to be all sorts of wonderful activities and programs. If and when you have to go to use the bathroom or get a drink of water, things of that sort, do not wander off. Please stay where you're supposed to. We also are going to have, alhamdulillah, security on staff. They are going to be around in the parking lot, in the facility. We ask that you please follow the directions that they give. The red lines have recently been painted, showing you where you cannot park and should not stop, because those are fire zones. Please make sure that you don't do that. If you're going to drop people off, please be considerate that you're going to have probably cars behind you and that you're going to cause traffic. So come early. This way, inshallah ta'ala, you can minimize anything of these sorts of inconveniences for yourself and for the rest, especially anything of a worse situation happening. Jama'ah, we ask that inshallah ta'ala you also pay attention to the other volunteers that are going to be working on IANT's safety and security committee. They will have something that identifies them. please cooperate with them, work with them. They are going to have walkie-talkies to communicate with each other and make dua for them and for us all. These brothers and sisters are sacrificing their precious Ramadan time for your well-being so that you can worship with peace of mind. And that's a tremendous act of selflessness for your wellness. And so we ask that Allah Azza wa Jal bless us all and help us all so that as we work together, that this experience will be a most beautiful, a most rewarding one for us all. We ask Him Jalla wa Ala that He help us and make easy for us the worship of Him, the beautiful remembrance of Him, and that He accept all that we do for Him. Allahumma ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.